गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल इन इंग्लिश लेक्चर. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द टॉपिक अनाउंसमेंट एंड वन ग्रामर टॉपिक नेम्ड डिग्रीज ऑफ कंपैरिजन. सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वील कंप्लीट द रिमेनिंग टू चैप्टर्स ऑफ योर इंग्लिश टेक्स्ट बुक यूनिट वन. सो today we are going to start with the next or new lesson, chapter number 7, Major Dhyan Chand. So I request you all to be ready with your English textbook, your English notebook and carry pen pencil in your hand. Now dear students, I request you all to take out your textbook page number 16. Lesson Major Dhyan Chand is written by Sanjay Dudhane. It is a very inspiring one which tells us about the hockey finals played against Germany during the Olympic events held at Berlin in Germany on 15th August 1936. And the German team had defeated many teams to reach the finals. But the Indian team was not very comfortable on wet ground, and unluckily for them it had rained heavily the day before the final match, and they were in foreign land and the stadium was filled with Germans with only a few Indians to cheer them. The captain of the team, Dhyan Chand, kept his cool and along with his team played a wonderful match, taking our country to victory and defeating the Germans in their hometown. So the skill showed by our captain was appreciated even by the German dictator, and Hitler awarded him with a special gold medal. So Major Dhyan Chand, he was born on 29th August 1905 and died on 3rd December 1979. So in 1936, 15th August 1936, hockey finals were held between India and Germany, and Germany hosted 1936 Olympics. So he won the three gold medals in 1928, 1932 and 1936. So dear children, now let's read the chapter to understand it more better. Come back to your page number 18. Just open your textbook, page number 16. Page number 16, lesson number 7, Major Dhyan Chand. Saturday, 15th August 1936. It was the day of the hockey finals during the Olympics events held in Berlin, Germany. Germany had defeated several teams to enter the finals against the Indian team. They were the host of the Olympics and they were sure of their victory. Perhaps that was the reason why their ruler, Hitler, had himself come to watch the match. So dear students, this match was held, or this Olympics was held at Berlin in Germany on 15th August 1936. And the German team had defeated many teams to reach the finals. So the Indian team was not very comfortable, and these finals, hockey finals, so as you all know, hockey is a national game of India. I know that it is not well played or well famous in India, but it is one of the famous, or national game of India. Usually you might be having some misunderstanding that always there is a cricket match, IPL and all. So it's not that क्रिकेट इज द नेशनल गेम, हॉकी इज द नेशनल गेम ऑफ इंडिया. वेल इट्स नॉट मोस्टली प्लेड बट इट्स वेरी पॉपुलर गेम स्पेशली इन फॉरेन कंट्रीज. सो ऑन सैटरडे 15th August and 1936 it was the day of hockey finals, and there were during hockey finals were during the Olympic events was held in Berlin in Germany. So Germany had defeated several teams against the Indian teams, so they were the host of the Olympics and they were sure of their victory because they had defeated many of the teams. So perhaps that was the reason why their ruler Hitler had himself come to watch the match. So students, as Germany was the host of the Olympics and they were sure of their victory, so this made Hitler the ruler of the Germany. Hence, he himself came to watch the match. Now, you all know the Hitler. So, Hitler was the ruler of Germany. So, he himself also came to watch the match because he was also knowing that at the end, Germany will win the victory. The victory will be of Germany only. All the day before, it had rained heavily. The entire field had become waterlogged. But 15th August, being the last day of the games, it was not possible to postpone the match any further. The Indian team was a little under pressure as they had lost to Germany in the practice match and they were not very comfortable with the wet ground. So dear students, the German team was going to play against the Indian team which is held in the Olympics, which is held in Berlin. Now Berlin is a place in Germany. Okay, it is a small city in Germany. So the Indian team was under pressure because before the match began because they had lost to Germany in the practice match. Now you all know before the final match there is a practice match. So in the practice match, the Indian team was under pressure because before the match began, they had lost to the Germany in practice match, and on behalf of that, they were not very comfortable with the wet ground because one day before the match, it rained heavily in Germany. So the ground was very wet and the Indian teams was not very comfortable because unluckily for them, it had rained very heavily the day before the final match. And it was not possible to postpone the match because as 15th August being the last day of the games, so the Indian team was a little under pressure. And let's see further what happens. About 40,000 people had gathered in the hockey stadium to cheer Germany against India. The Maharaja of Baroda State, the Prince of Bhopal and a few other Indians had also come to support the Indian team. So dear students, about 40,000 people had gathered in the hockey stadium to cheer Germany against India. So for the Germany, they were in a foreign land and the stadium was filled with Germans. So the stadium was filled with Germans with only few Indians to cheer them. And there were many foreigners filled with Germans to cheer up the Germany. But there were only few Indians to cheer the Indians. Now, the Maharaja of Baroda State and the Prince of Bhopal and a very few other Indians had come to support the Indian team. Very few only Indians had come to support the Indian team, and there were many of the Germans to support the Germany. The match started exactly at 11 a.m. The German team had adopted a novel strategy of using the Indian technique of short distance passes against the Indian team itself. They had resorted to a very aggressive play. The Indian team was offering an equally strong resistance. No team could make a goal during the first half hour. During the 32nd minute, Rup Singh scored the first goal, hitting the ball towards the goal post from a difficult angle. So students, now here, the match started exactly at 11 a.m. in morning, and the German team had adopted a novel strategy of using the Indian technique of short distance passes against the Indian team itself. And the Germans resorted to a very aggressive play means very, to attack unjustly. Aggressive play means what? To attack unjustly. So the Germans resorted to a very aggressive play, and the Indian team was offering an equally strong resistance. Strong resistance means what? Withstand the action. Strong resistance, refusing to accept. So the Indian team was also refusing to accept them because they had a strong resistance, and no team could make a goal during the first half hour. So first half hour, no team would make a goal. But during the 32nd minute, Rup Singh from the Indian team scored the first goal by hitting the ball towards the goal post from a difficult angle. So the first goal was hit by the Indians named Rup Singh. And how did he score the first goal? He scored the first goal by hitting the ball towards the goal post from a difficult angle. In the second half of the match, the Indian team found a firm footing. The entire team played as one and made three more goals against Germany. Two of them were made by the captain of the Indian team, Dhyan Chand. However, the German players were also trying their level best to win. They too have succeeded in making one goal. So dear students, now the Dhyan Chand, he was the captain of Indian team. And in the second half of the match, Indian team found a firm footing. And the entire team of Indians played as one and made three more goals against Germany. So the first goal was made by the Rup Singh. He scored the first goal, and another three more goals were made by Indians against the Germany. And among those three more goals, two of them were made by the captain himself of the Indian team named Dhyan Chand. However, the Germans were also not less. The German players were also trying their level best to win, and they too succeeded in making one goal. Now, Indians had made how many goals? Four. And whereas Germany had succeeded in making one goal. Now, only a few last minutes were left. Dhyan Chand had resolved to win. Resolve means what, students? Yes, resolve means decided. Now, only few last minutes were remaining. Now, as you all know, when you are playing in sport, so when the last few minutes are left, you are trying your level best. You have decided earlier that you will win. So you're trying your level best to win. So same manner with the Dhyan Chand, the last few minutes were remaining and the Dhyan Chand had decided to win. Now children, now just turn your page. Just open your textbook, page number 17. The match at any cost without allowing Germany to make any more goals. His spiked shoes were making it difficult for him to run fast on the wet ground. He removed the shoes and the socks and began to run barefoot. Using his amazing skill of dribbling and his near magical game, he began to send one pass after another to the players in the D, that is, in the defenders or opponents area from where they could make goals. They too did not let the passes go waste. The Indian team scored 3 more goals. Dhyan Chand could have easily made the goals himself from his own position, but he never played a selfish game. Skillfully, he took the ball away from the Germans' defenders and made it possible for the players in the D to score goals. So, dear students, here in this case, Dhyan Chand could have easily made the goals himself, but because of the spiked shoes. Now, what do you mean by spiked shoes? Yes, spiked shoes means what? Children, spiked shoes means the racing shoes. The spiked shoes are usually used by the athletes for racing purpose. Okay, to play a sport. So students, now the match, already the Dhyan Chand had decided to win, and the spiked shoes with Dhyan Chand was wearing was making it difficult for him to run fast on the wet ground. That is why what he did, he removed his shoes and socks and started playing barefoot. Barefoot means without shoes. So Dhyan Chand, he had decided to win. So he was playing with the full dedication. He was trying his level best to win. So the spiked shoes were making it difficult, and for that purpose he just removed the shoes and socks and began to run without shoes, with barefoot. Using his amazing skill of dribbling and his near magical game, so he began to send one pass after another to play in the D. So dear students, Dhyan Chand could have easily made the goals himself from his own position, but he did not do so. He skillfully took the ball away from the German defenders and made it possible for Indian players in the D to score goals. This shows that Dhyan Chand was not a selfish person. So they too did not let the passes go waste. The Indian team scored 3 more goals here, and Dhyan Chand could have made easily himself from his own position, but he never played a selfish game. Yes, Dhyan Chand could have easily made the goals himself from his own position, but he never played a selfish game. Skillfully, he took the ball away from the German defenders and make it possible for players in the D to score the goals. So, Dhyan Chand, he just skillfully took the ball away from the German defenders and it make possible for Indian players in the D to score the goals. So, this shows us that Dhyan Chand was not a selfish person. The German strategy had proved fruitless. A defeat stared them in the face. Some of the frustrated German players then resorted to a rough game. The German goalkeeper pounced on Dhyan Chand and hurt him. But Dhyan Chand was a true soldier. After a little first aid, he immediately returned to the field and held the spectators spellbound with his game. At last, he scored the last goal of the match just as the game drew to a close. The Indian team had won third time in a row. It was a hat trick. Indians were the third time winners of the Olympic gold medal. So, dear students, when the Germans knew that they would be defeated, they resorted to a rough game. Now, why did Germans resort to a rough game? Because they knew that they would be defeated by the Indians. So the German goalkeeper, he just pounced on the Dhyan Chand, hurting him. But the Dhyan Chand, he was a true soldier. After a little first aid, he immediately returned to the field and held the spectators spellbound with his game. So the German goalkeeper, when he pounced on the Dhyan Chand, then hurt him. But after a little first, Dhyan Chand immediately returned to the field. And Dhyan Chand scored the last goal of the match just as the game drew to a close. And the Indian team won third time in a row. It was a hat trick. Indians were the third time winners of the Olympic gold medal. Although Hitler left the stadium before the match was over, he had impressed by Dhyan Chand's game. It is said that the German dictator had offered Dhyan Chand a higher salary and rank in the German army if he agreed to play on behalf of Germany, but Dhyan Chand turned down the offer. After the celebrated victory in the Olympics, Hitler awarded a special gold medal to Dhyan Chand. You may be aware that hockey is a national sport. Major Dhyan Chand's birthday, August 29, is celebrated as National Sports Day in India. The famous National Stadium in Delhi is named after the great hero Dhyan Chand. Who knows, perhaps one of you may carry the legacy of Dhyan Chand further and win great glory for our country. So, dear students, as you all know, the Hitler, you may have heard the name Hitler, who was the ruler of the Germany. He was very, in other words, he was a very aggressive person who used to get angry first. He used to get angry fast, and he was one of the dangerous person, dangerous ruler. So, Hitler also left the stadium before the match was over. He was impressed by Dhyan Chand's game, and it is said that German dictator offered Dhyan Chand a higher salary and rank in German army if he agreed to play on behalf of Germany. So the Major Dhyan Chand, he was offered to play on behalf of Germany. So if Major Dhyan Chand, he would agree with the dictator and he would accept his offer. Dhyan Chand would be given a higher salary and rank in the German army. But Dhyan Chand turned down the tempting offer made to him by Hitler, which shows us that he was a true patriot. And the August 29th is celebrated as National Sports Day in India. And you all know that Hitler awarded a special gold medal to Dhyan Chand. So after the celebration victory in the Olympics, Hitler awarded Dhyan Chand with a special gold medal. And you may be knowing that as I told you all in the starting, hockey is a national sport. So, Major Dhyan Chand's birthday falls on August 29, and that day is celebrated as a national sports day in India. And also there is a famous national stadium in Delhi is named after the great hero Dhyan Chand. Number 18, students, the more information is given about the chapter 7, Major Dhyan Chand. Let's try to understand it. Hockey stick used to come alive in the hands of Dhyan Chand. When it dribbled, the ball just wouldn't leave his stick. Some people even stole his stick and broke them open to see whether they contained a special glue or magnet. Dhyan Chand was even made to play with other ordinary sticks, but even then his play wasn't charismatic as ever. Dhyan Chand's real name was Dhyan Singh. He was a soldier in the Indian Army. He couldn't practice his game during the day because he used to be busy on his duty as a soldier. That is why he used to practice at night in moonlight. It is believed that his coach fondly began to call him Dhyan Chand. Chand means moon. So the name stayed with him. So dear students, the lifeless hockey stick used to come alive in Dhyan Chand's hands. Some people stole and broke Dhyan Chand's hockey sticks to see whether they contained a special glue or magnet, because whenever Dhyan Chand dribbled, the ball wouldn't leave his stick. And Dhyan Chand was a soldier in the Indian Army. He was very busy in his duty as a soldier during the day, and hence he practiced at the night in the moonlight. So Dhyan Singh used to practice at night in the moonlight. Hence his coach fondly called him Dhyan Chand. Chand means what? Moon. So this name stayed with him because his real name was Dhyan Singh. So dear students, I hope so that you have understood this chapter very well. Now this chapter meanings and question answers I will send to you all through WhatsApp. Now the meanings you are supposed to write in your English notebook itself, and the question answers of this chapter you are supposed to write in your combined book. Now dear children, let's proceed to our next small chapter, chapter number 8, peer profile. Chapter number 8, peer profile. So students, this chapter, page number 19, this is the last chapter of your unit 1. So this chapter shows you an excellent way to improve your writing skills and will surely add to your vocabulary too. So this chapter helps you to write a report. We will be writing a report on peer profile. A report on peer profile means a systematic, well-organized presentation of information got especially of your friends, students of your age. So this chapter peer profile will help you to understand that a report has to be written to the point without too much of description. Report helps to summarize what is written. So the presentation of a report can be oral or written. So while preparing a peer profile, students automatically acquire language skills like speaking in a polite manner, gathering informations, putting it together in a relevant manner, and preparing a brief report in an interesting way. So do's and don'ts while preparing a report on peer profile are: sentences should be to the point and precise. Second, too much of description is not required. You are supposed to write in short. Third, presentation should be clear. Fourth, what is not mentioned should be pointed out. Fifth, personal remarks should be avoided. 6. statements and emotions should not be hurt. Seventh, interesting points should be mentioned at the end. So let's try to understand, or let's improve the language skills and writing skills with the help of this lesson, peer profiles. Get 10 of your friends to fill in this sheet for you. My name, Anisha Kishore Ambekar. At home, they call me. Third point is given, my friends call me. Some of the things I enjoy. Some of the things I appreciate. Some of the things I fear. Some of the things I hate to do. Some of the things I have to do. Some of the things I will never do. Some of my good habits. Some of my bad habits. My favorite personality. What I like most about this person. So dear students, this peer profile. Peer means someone is of your age. This peer profile, you can write about your friends which are of your age, or any classmates from your class. So here the points are mentioned. So your name. So here, for example, it's given Anisha Kishore Ambekar. At home, they call me Sona. My friends call me Nisha. Some of the things I enjoy, swimming, ice cream. Some of the things I appreciate, music, good handwriting. Some of the things I fear, a mouse, singing in front of the class. Some of the things I hate to do, cut onions. Why cut onions? You all like to cut onions? No, because while cutting onions, we cry, no? The tears are there in our eyes. Onion makes us to cry. Some of the things I have to do, get up early in the morning. You all also get lazy to wake up early in the morning and to get ready for the school. Some of the things I will never do, tell a lie to my mother. Some of my good habits, brushing teeth twice a day. It's a good habit. Some of the students also, among you all brush the teeth twice in a day. Once in the morning and once in the night before going to bed. Some of my bad habits, stuffing my clothes in the cupboard without folding them. Yes, there are brilliant and multi-talented students among you all who don't fold their clothes properly and keep in cupboard. You directly stuffed all the clothes in the cupboard without folding them. So this is also one of the bad habits of the Anisha Ambekar. My favorite personality, Mahendra Singh Dhoni. What I like most about this person, he is a very good captain. Now understood page number 19. Let's proceed to the page number 20. On page number 20, let's continue. After you have collected the filled in sheets from your friends, go through all of them and make notes for each of the points. Use the notes to write a report about your friends, likes, dislikes, habits, favorite, personalities, etc. You can present your report orally or in writing. Remember the following things when you make a written oral presentation. So students, you have to make the note. While first thing is, you have distributed those sheets to your friends so that they will fill their profile and they will return back to you. And once you have collected the filled in sheets from your friends, you have to go through all of them and make note for each of the points to make the report. So their likes, dislikes, habits, personalities, etc. So you can present your report orally or in writing. And you have to make the report that yes, so and so number of students or so and so number of your friends, they like this, they dislike that particular thing. So you have to write a report orally or in written, And to write this report, oral or written, you need to remember some points for presentation. The points are, you need not mention the names of your friends in your presentation. You should only give a summary of what you observe in the responses given by many people. Understood? So students, there is no need to mention your friend's name in your presentation. You have to just give a summary of what you observe. Your presentation should clearly show that many or most people enjoy, appreciate, fear, etc. What only some of them mention and what only one or two mention. You have to clearly mention that most of the people enjoy, appreciate, fear, etc. So you have to mention in number. No need to mention the names. And the presentation should be very clear. If necessary, you may point out what is not mentioned by any of the people. For example, you may say, it appears that nobody is afraid of examination, as no one has included them in the things they fear. So in the peer profile, there was one point that one of the bad things in my life, so, or the thing which I hate the most. So if your friends, if there is a majority of your friends who have not mentioned a certain point, then you can write in that presentation that this so and so number has not mentioned the fear of examination, as no one has included them in the things they fear. You should also mention what you found most interesting in the responses at the end of your presentation. So you should also mention what you found most interesting responses. You have to highlight that point. What interesting reply you found, that you have to write at the end of your presentation. You must take care to see that you do not hurt anyone's feelings when you get the sheets filled or when you make your presentation. So students, while making the presentation or while making the oral or written report, you should keep one thing in mind, that it should not hurt anyone's feelings while making your presentation. So this is a language oriented sub project, and therefore it is necessary that students do independently with many language skills, like approaching people politely, putting together information gathered under the proper categories in the relevant manner. So dear students, as you all know, the peer profile, this was a project for you all. So what I am doing, the questions, the peer profile, which is given in your textbook, page number 19. So that peer profile